Hi, it's me again, Jessamine, and welcome back for another video. And this one is from day 11 from our hashtag What's in the House. And I'm gonna sketch my favorite art materials, sketching materials. Normally I use daily. So actually I have also a lot of colors, brush pens and everything, fine liners and a lot of inks. But at the end of the day, I only use these materials. Because it's easy to make a decision when you have less. So, lesson learned. Sometimes you don't need too much to start sketching. Just use something that you really like and comfortable to use with. Especially for urban sketcher, because you sketch outside. And also bring something that you always like to use. Because, you know, you want to make a nice result after the 3 hours of your sketching maximum or something like that. So it's better to just get used to your style, your materials, and you always get a nice result when you're out there. If you're not sure with your materials, I rather just first practice it at home before you carry it there outside and make a sketch. But of course it's your choice. You can also experiment if you want. I normally just use these things even if I'm home. I always use my sketchbook from Koval, which is 100% cotton and also 60 pages, and is I think it's 300 GSM, so it's really thick enough to carry all, to hold a lot of water. And what I like with cotton paper is that they're so forgiving. So if I have mistakes on coloring with watercolor, I can easily remove it with water, and that's very good. That's fun. So one thing you really like to have when you do watercolor. And also with fine liner, I don't really use too much fine liner anymore, although I have a lot of fine liners on my table. But lately I just used two fountain pen from Lamy Sapari. So I use waterproof ink on my fountain pen. That is from Sketch Ink. And also from fine liner, I only use most of the time 0.25 fine liner. And I also use Pigma brush pen from Sakura, the waterproof one. It's really good for rough sketches. Sometimes if I want to make a fast sketch, I use also brush pen to have the sketchy look. Posca fine liner white for my highlights. That's what I mostly use. And then, with ink, I used from Roro and Klingner, the sketch ink from Lotta and Thea. I think it was a Thea that is more grayish. And it's almost look like, Thea is grayish color, gray color. It almost looks like black. So. They're all both waterproof, so it's good to use for combining with watercolor. Brushes, I use most three brands from Da Vinci, round brush, and also the Rosemary number 772 Sable Blend. And also Winsor & Newton round brush number 4. Was it number 4? Let me see for you guys. Because I don't really show it on a sketch. But I know it for myself that it was something like, you know, number 4, I think. I think it's number 4. And also, sable hair. But I also sometimes use synthetic hair. It's also good. I know already. I can see it already from here. It's number four. Yeah, that's number four. So those are the brushes that I mostly use. I don't use any more water brush. Sometimes I still have from Faber-Castell and also from Sakura. Every now and then I use it for quick sketching, urban sketching. And then if you want to use pencil, please use the good quality eraser, because it really helps a lot. If you really buy a cheap eraser because you think, oh, it's just an eraser, you don't have to invest too much for that. No, because if you really want to, especially if you really draw too hard and you want to remove it after you do the final lines, and you really need to make sure that it's not gonna ruin your paper, and also it's not gonna ruin your sketch, and it's gonna smudge the ink. So I prefer more. I love to use the Tombow Dust Catch Mono. It's really good one because it doesn't make too much mess. And my palette is combined with all 21 colors from different brands: Winsor & Newton, Renaissance, White Nights, Vincent van Gogh, Rembrandt, all mix up. I don't know the names because I just use it and then check it if it's okay. If it's not okay, oh well, next time do it better. So I have 21 colors and that's it. I don't want to make it more because I don't want to make a decision too long for what color should I use this and that. I just want to everything be easy and to enjoy my sketching, not too much making a decision what color I'm gonna use. I just look and then use it, and if it's not good, then better luck next time. Sorry, that's how I do it with my life nowadays. Before I always do that, but now no, it's okay. Prima Marketing brand is also good watercolor. I also use brush pens for my last final touch on my sketches, just to give a little bit of spice on my drawing to make it a little bit intense. But in this sketch, I didn't use it. I think I only use it on some part, like Lamy Safari, the color of Lamy Safari, and also the sketchbook, because the model, the things that I use to sketch is not really too much color, except for the color palette or the watercolor. That's the only thing here with colors, and the rest is just normal color, like grayish tone, like the pens and the brushes, things like that. The only thing that's really with color here is the Lamy Safari, so that's why I didn't use my brush pen here because I don't really need it, which is okay because it's also look more lighter. You know me, I always like intense color. All right, so yeah, that's this sketchbook is, by the way, with thick rubber band. It's really good because it's always a stretch the warp of my paper once I use too much water, and that's one thing I really like with this. And also, if I'm going outside, I just put my pens there and they're stuck together, so if I need it, they're just in. Ideal for sketching outside. I think a Koval sketchbook really mean to do this for that. So you can also carry all the way anywhere you want. So here I actually have a mistake here. I put too much color. Sometimes I need to learn how to stop, when to stop, because in this process I put too much red on my sketchbook, on the sketchbook that I'm sketching. And thank God I'm using a cotton paper. So it's easily to remove once you made a mistake, once you put too much. Like for example, here, I think I added a brush pen here, a red brush pen on my sketch. And then it went too bright and I didn't like it. So what I did is just I wet it again and then put some kitchen paper in it to dab it with kitchen paper on top to remove some ink, and then it went lighter again, so that's good. So you will see it later. So I always do first light and then dark, as you can see, which is logic, because you want to see first the dark value, the light value, and then the dark value. And then for the last time, I add gel pen. See it here? I put brush pen and then I just dab it with paper and then it went light again. So the last part is the gel pen, the fine liner to highlight some things and the details, all the small details, some textures. I added all for the last part of my sketches. So then I know, is it necessary or is it not? So that's why I always added later on the details, lines and textures. So that's it. Thank you for watching, and I hope I'm gonna see you again next time on weekend to show you the 7 challenges I made for you for the next coming days after our 14 days challenge. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Please follow me on Instagram at Jessamine Creates and also YouTube at Jessamine Creates. Bye.